السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to tonight's Taraweeh Reflection. Today we are in Surah Al-Muzzammil. We're going to be covering the first few ayat, inshallah. This surah starts and Allah says, Ya ayyuha al-Muzzammil, O you who is wrapped up, referring to the Prophet wrapped up meaning in clothing or in garments. Scholars have also mentioned a very interesting point, subhanAllah. They say that the Prophet is referred to as Muzzammil, wrapped up, because he is now wrapped up, clothed with the responsibility of prophethood. And then Allah says, قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, stand the night except for a little bit, meaning stand the night in prayer, meaning pretty much the whole night. نِصْفَهُ أَوْ انْقُسْ مِنْهُ قَلِيلًا أَوْ زِدْ عَلَيْهِ, so half of the night in prayer, or a little bit less than that, or add to that. This is the قيام الليل, or night prayer, that was obligated upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam when he received the message of Islam. وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, and recite the Qur'an with measured recitation. And this is what is done during قيام الليل, is the recitation. إِنَّا سَنُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلًا ثَقِيلًا, certainly we are sending down upon you a heavy, weighty word, meaning the Qur'an first and foremost, and then everything that comes with the message. This is the beginning of the Risala, the beginning of the message of Islam, and the Prophet is about to embark on a huge journey. And we find that one of the first things that Allah obligates upon the Prophet, the first things that Allah obligates upon the Prophet is this night prayer, spending at least a portion of the night in prayer and the recitation of the Quran during the night. And Allah tells the Prophet that this is a heavy, weighty word, this is a big responsibility that you're about to take on. You need this, you need the night prayer. And that's why for us, when we are going through difficulties in life or we're having troubles in life or hardship, one of the first places we should turn to is the Quran and the recitation of the Quran during the نَاشِئَةَ اللَّيْلِ هِيَ أَشَدُّ وَطَأً وَأَقْوَى مُقِيلًا. Certainly, these hours of the night, or rising during the night, is the most effective. It is the most effective for governing or taking control of the heart, and وَأَقْوَى مُقِيلًا, and it is the most suitable word. So when going through difficult times, we need to take control of our nafs. We need to take control of our heart and our soul, ourself. And one of the ways we do that is through this qiyam. No matter what's going on during the day and what you go through and how many hardships and stress and difficulty, this time, the night time, is where you take control. It is the night time and in this night prayer and the night recitation of the Quran that you find peace and comfort and you find rest for your restless heart. أَقْوَى مُقِيلًا, and this time, this action of قيام الليل is the most suitable for the word. So the recitation of the Quran, the understanding of the Quran, the effectiveness of the Quran for us. So if we really want to be moved by the Quran, if we really want our hearts to be affected by the Quran, then we need قيام الليل is a necessary part of our relationship with the Quran. So with everything else we do during the day, recitation, memorization, etc., etc., we need this قيام الليل. Also, أَقْوَى مُقِيلًا, most suitable word, is the idea that when we are going through difficulties or hardships, we need to talk to someone. We might need to complain to someone. We might need to pour our heart out to someone. We need that in difficult times. And the best time to do it is the night prayer with Allah. If you want that burden to be eased, to be lifted off of yourself, then speak to Allah. Pour your heart out to Allah in the night prayer with this qiyam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. I'll talk to y'all later, inshallah ta'ala. Take care. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.